I am going to fucking kill Nick Sparks.
I am going to fucking kill Nick Sparks.
I am going to fucking kill Nick Sparks.
And now we continue with part 4 of the 7-part series. My little sister disappeared 3 years ago. No one remembers her except me.
Finding yourself in the talons of an owl and the shadows of the forest moonlight.
It's a gruesome affair.
I stared at the back of that paper for a long time, growing angrier every second I looked at it. But I knew that getting angry wouldn't help me solve what the hell this fucking bastard was doing to my sister. I needed to get to the bottom of this, fast. By what I could tell from the report, Zoe was also given whatever the fuck this mind control solution was. Does this mean that when I go and find her, she won't remember me? And if not, what do I have to do to make her remember? Will she come back to her senses when she sees my face again? Will I ever even get to see her again? Questions were racing through my mind, and at some point, Noah slid down to see what the hell was going on.
Hey, what the hell did you find?
I didn't say anything. I just handed him the piece of paper with Zoe's picture on it. Noah took a hold of it, and he stared at it, squinting.
Sorry, I can't see very well. Can you shine your phone on it?
I did, as he asked. After a good 10 seconds of him staring, I noticed that there was something wrong with him. He wasn't moving, talking, or blinking at all.
Noah?
No reaction. I shone my phone up to his eyes, and I almost immediately jumped back. There was something happening with his eyes. It was almost like images were rapidly flashing in front of him that only he could see. They were making Noah's eyes change color extremely rapidly. Noah dropped the photo, and suddenly both of his hands were pulling at his hair. He was now screaming in agony, and he fell to the floor, writhing on the ground, still gripping his head.
Noah, what the fuck is happening to you?
I yelled at him as I tried to take hold of him and make him calm down. It didn't take me very long to realize that I couldn't do anything at all until whatever the fuck this was over. I just brought my knees up to my chest and wrapped my arms around my legs as I stared terrified at Noah, who was still screaming, "What the fuck is happening?" I don't remember how long it took for Noah to stop screaming, but as soon as he did stop, I crawled over to him as he was still lying on the ground.
"Noah,"
I asked him as I shook him. His eyes immediately opened. His eyes met mine, and it looked like he was crying. But at the same time, he gave me a look that was filled with pity.
"What's wrong, Noah?"
He got up from the ground, and he immediately hugged me.
"What's up with this reaction? The fuck has gotten into you, dude?"
I asked him.
I'm so sorry I didn't remember her. I'm sorry I treated you like you were crazy all these years," he said, choking up.
I realized what this meant.
Wait, you remember Zoe now?
Noah released me, and he nodded, still crying. With this realization, I immediately bolted to the box that was labeled as pictures. I ripped open the box and dumped all the pictures out. Seeing all of the pictures of Zoe that were in this box made me want to kill Nick even more. It was obvious from these pictures that Nick was stalking my family for a very long time. I saw one picture that was different. It was just a single picture of a man I felt like I recognized. I picked it up and shone my light on it to see it clearer. Nick Sparks.
Nick Sparks.
The thought ran involuntarily through my head. I cried out in pain, my head exploded with a head-splitting headache, and I immediately dropped to the ground. I kept my eyes open because I realized that this could be the exact same thing that happened to Noah. Out of the corner of my eye, I saw Noah bolt towards me. I focused on what was about to happen. Images, memories that I didn't even know were there, flashed before me.
My heart dropped to the deepest pit of my stomach. In these images, I saw my family, but I also saw the man I knew now as Nick Sparks. He was there all along, the whole fucking time. I saw my mom holding Zoe as a baby, with my dad standing beside her, but there was also Nick staring at the baby that my mom was holding dearly in her arms. I saw more and more images of Nick, always with our family. It felt like I was looking at images where he was photoshopped in unnaturally. But I remembered him now. Nick Sparks was a friend of our family. That was why my parents asked him to deliver Zoe. We trusted Nick wholeheartedly as a family friend. He was always there for me and Zoe's birthdays too. As soon as these images stopped running through my head and I was no longer in agony, I sat up. I knew at that moment that I wouldn't give up on killing Nick. He betrayed our family. He turned my parents against me. And most of all, he took my fucking sister. But I knew that I made progress. I found a very obvious weakness to whatever this mind control solution was. It was apparent that he tried to use it on me too, but it didn't work as planned. Or maybe it did. Maybe it was planned. I realized that Noah was trying to talk to me to get answers from what just happened.
What did you just see?
He sounded evidently worried. Nick Sparks. I knew him. I began taking all the pictures of Zoe that I could that I thought could be useful. There were pictures of me too, which made me feel even more nauseous, but I knew I may have to take these too. I knew what I was going to do next. I had to make my parents remember Zoe. After I finished picking up all the pictures and files that I thought would be important, I said to Noah, "Come on, let's get the fuck out of here." Noah, bless his heart, came with me to my house to try to help my parents regain their memories of Zoe. I decided that I wouldn't show them the photo of Nick though. I wanted to kill him, and I didn't want anything to get in my way. If my parents remembered him, they may try to stop me. As I walked up to my house, I felt extremely guilty of what I did to my parents before. Regardless, I continued and I knocked on the door. I didn't feel like I should just walk in. My dad opened the door and when he saw me, he didn't look too thrilled, but he let me inside, along with Noah. When I got both of my parents together, I apologized to them about my obnoxious and violent behavior from the other night, and that I told them I wouldn't let it happen again. "But please, I have something extremely important to show you," I said to them.
"I swear to God, if this has anything to do with that imaginary little sister, I do not want to see your face again for a long time."
My dad snapped at me. My mom just looked at me with a concerned look on her face. I ignored my dad's threat and brought out the pictures of Zoe, which I picked up from Nick's old house. I laid them on the table for them to look at. Something was wrong though. They didn't seem to have any signs of recognizing Zoe. They looked back to me with blank and angry stares. Noah looked at me with a scared expression. We were thinking the same thing. Why the fuck aren't they reacting to these photos like Noah did?
"What the actual fuck is this supposed to be? Why do you have these random pictures of a fucking little girl? Are you sick?"
My dad was yelling at me now. "I don't understand. Why don't they remember?" I grabbed Noah's arm and quickly bolted out of my house. I was lightheaded.
"Why the hell don't they remember like I did?"
Noah asked, running his hands through his hair. He looked like he was about to panic too. I didn't know how to answer his question. I felt my phone vibrate in my pocket. As I pulled my phone out of my pocket, something in my heart knew that it was going to be something bad.
"Unknown number. Sorry, but it's not going to be that easy. From NS.
From NS.
To my forest friends, thank you for listening to another tale. I hope you enjoy these horrible stories as much as I do. If so, please rip at the like button and scratch a comment. And be sure to subscribe so we can visit here on the Smoking Owl Tales channel next time. And catch you on another night very soon.
And catch you on another night very soon. Catch you on another night very soon.